What is a TV show you got really far into but eventually quit watching before its conclusion? Walking Dead, for sure. It never went anywhere. I wanted a conclusion, a solution, something new that wasn't killing and fighting other people. I wanted smart solutions, but they never arrived. My favorite bit was when they went to the place that was safe, but it turned out it wasn't safe and all the zombies came along in that. What about the bit where they discover some other survivors who turn out to be hostile? I was shitting on the show for a couple seasons, but the sunk cost fallacy kept me watching. Until the moment Rick finally had Negan in his sights, dead to rights, and again is like this time, you better be telling the truth, Negan. Not like the other 25 times where you weren't telling the truth, but this time by God you better be. So I won't shoot you even though I could and should, because surely this time you're going to honor your word. I was like, duck this goddamn terrible show, I just can't waste my time anymore. You made it farther than me. I stopped once I realized that the show was never going to decide if it wanted to follow the comics or do its own thing. Like, why kill off characters at odd times only to replace them with new people who follow the comic route? It's irritating. Orange is the New Black in The Walking Dead. And Piper just got so unbearable to watch. That seems to be Cohen's thing problem. The protagonist in Weeds became insufferable as well. I definitely agree with you, but just wanted to add that every character on Weeds became insufferable. Last episode of season 3 they left Agrestic, and from there on it was all downhill. I stopped watching Weeds somewhere around the end of the season where she was dating the Mexican mayor guy, and I realized that I absolutely hated everyone on the show. Same. It got too ridiculous even by TV standards. They could have stretched the rich white lady selling weed in her cul-de-sac for a few quality seasons and ended it with the fire. Grey's Anatomy, how much trauma can a group of doctors go through? Sheesh. That's one of the biggest things that irks me. The first hospital shooting in season 6, I think, was pretty intense. By the third or fourth brain tumor, explosion, fire, terrorist bomb or whatever, it's just sloppy. The shooting episode was fantastically done, really got at the tension of the situation and you were really afraid for the characters' lives when they started killing them off left and right. It got old fast, though. It's a medical show. Just have them get another job, you don't have to kill characters to write them off. Once upon a time. Can't even remember where I got to. Seriously. The first season was so incredible, beautiful storytelling, deep characters, and then it just never recovered the original feel of season 1. I stopped at some point and have rewatched season 1 a few times but never finished the series. I feel like this was written to be a one season and done series, then after the success they couldn't let it go, so just kept going without any real plan. Hey, that sounds a lot like what happened with Prison Break. They actually escaped from prison at the end of season 1. There are 5 seasons. Nope. I'm out. Arrow, got tired of the main character flip-flopping from season to season. Felt he was hypocritical when he killed people in the first season and then hunted down people doing the same thing he did in the next, only for him to go back to kill people in the following season. I got so far with all the Arrowverse shows and then they all slowly became like a teen drama with Power Ranger budget fight scenes. Power Ranger budget fight scenes. The drop in fight quality was downright confusing at some points. When Ollie had his sword showdown with Raz on the mountaintop, I legitimately thought he was intentionally throwing the fight because we'd spent 12 years watching him be a better fighter than that. Laurel had spent what, a couple weeks at most? Training with Wildcat, and was then able to go toe-to-toe with League of Assassin members. I know many times you just need fodder enemies so you can have some big fight scene showing heroes kicking ass, but it seriously killed any sort of tension or threatening presence the League could ever have again. I mean, the show shot itself in the foot in tons of other places too, but it's this example that really showed me they have choreography for group fights, and will just swap out characters as needed for the scene, and never update the choreography to suit the characters. Laurel had spent what, a couple weeks at most? Training with Wildcat, and was then able to go toe-to-toe with League of Assassin members. I know many times you just need fodder enemies so you can have some big fight scene showing heroes kicking ass, but it seriously killed any sort of tension or threatening presence the League could ever have again. This after 10 members of the League were described as an army and were able to take down super soldiers in the season 2 finale. Not to mention the retcon of Laurel's ability to defend herself established throughout season 1. they completely wasted the potential of having Roz and the League in the show. But instead of getting a League storyline where there's a real conflict based around the difference in the ways the two groups go about being vigilantes, instead they just recycled the same old Batman story again. Looking back, the dip in the writing quality started in season 2, but really took a nosedive in season 3. The finale of season 2 and the first episode of season 3 don't even seem like the same show. Once upon a time I just stopped caring, because it felt like none of the characters were actually developing and would just regress season to season. Edit, for clarity, I believe I finished season 5 before I couldn't be bothered to continue. Somewhere around. When Hades gets killed in Regina's office, and the main crew gets sent to Olympus and Hook resurrects. That's absolutely the main problem with what? Rumpel is redeemed. JK, he's plotting to kill his grandson. Actually, it's okay, he's redeemed. No, wait, he sold his baby. House of Cards. Well, before the spacey shit, but that was definitely the nail in the not finishing this coffin. The show was a lot more interesting when he and Claire were conniving their way to the presidency. When they succeed, it just turns into this half-baked international politicking thing, and I hated that they drove a wedge between Frank and Claire. Their sick relationship was the show for me. Yeah, the first season was top-notch television. I ended my viewing right before the season Claire took over. Spacey is all kinds of sick disgusting shit, but he gave his all in that performance. Spacey is a great actor. Hess so good in the stuff Hess in. Hess also a terrible human being. Suits. I really liked it to begin with. Soundtrack was a cracker. But it just turned into a soap opera, too much focus on the Rachel Mike thing. Shameless. I watched most of it and liked it, but don't recall finishing it. There's only so much wanton self-destruction that I can stomach, and that show hit my limit well before it wrapped. My GF introduced me to the show. I grew up in a poor neighborhood with family members on drugs, prison, gangs, all that shit. Her family is well-to-do, working class, but rural in a way that everything is pretty wholesome and easygoing. At first the show was really funny and relatable, but by like season 5, I didn't really feel like watching it anymore because it was just making me depressed. My GF didn't really understand until I explained that it just brings up so much shit that I got away from. Then my mom was murdered around the same time, and I think we both just avoided depressing movies and TV for like 6 months. After years of convincing me to finally watch it, explaining how why I love it so much, I sat through the pilot. My eyes were welled up by the end of the episode because I dated Fiona's who had dads who were Frank's a couple of seasons, and I was tired of rewatching all of my nightmares, awful memories replaying out before my eyes. Great writing, great casting, great show, but they made it a little too well for those who were all too familiar with that lifestyle. Edit, spelling. I got 18 seasons into Grey's Anatomy before I got irredeemably bored. That's probably the biggest sunk cost here. Edit, made it halfway through season 18. Didn't keep watching after the second half resumed. Ill return when Zola is an intern. Pretty Little Liars, that shit got too confusing for 16-year-old me. It was too confusing because they made an omnipotent being who was in 1,000 places at the same time with unlimited resources, lol. No, because please tell me why they made up 10 different characters, I was lost. The Blacklist was great until they ran out of ideas and just kept recycling the same plot over and over. The little guy from the DMV becoming a major player was the sign the end was near. The Blacklist fell apart because the entire theme was that there are machinations going on behind the scenes that tie everything together, and the only one with insight into what that is Reddington. At some point, the writing became too much making it up as we go, and the illusion of an overarching machination started to fall apart, and so did the entire draw of the show. This is why I stop watching shows. People come up with neat idea for a show, say a criminal mastermind informant for the FBI. Their neat idea revolves around you never finding out the truth. They can never tell you the truth, so the main plotline of the show has no ending, just cliffhanger after cliffhanger. Come up with a neat idea, and also some really big sub-ideas, so you have something that can look like an ending to the audience. Also, maybe write enough plot for an entire season, instead of enough plot for an episode or two and just stretching that out with useless crap. I'm no writer, I have no idea what that looks like. But I do know that I'd rather watch something like Star Trek TNG, where there were overarching plot lines, and occasional cliffhangers at season end, but for the most part you could just watch an episode and be happy. Now I get Star Trek Picard, which I cannot watch because all of season 1 was enough plot to be a two-part episode. I never even made it through season 2. It just seems like lazy writing that's hanging its coat on good special effects and an audience that's also on its phone, so they're not really paying attention.